We find that the Tamil prisoner was at Nagasi prison while he was demanding medical attention for a long period. He has been not given any medical attention. He has been neglected. Through negligence, this person has died. There he has been assaulted while he has been a prisoner and while he has been under detention. And he has claimed over and over again, demanded medical attention, and that has not been given. Then he would come out from the general inquiry that had held in prison. Sundaram Sahi. That is how he died in this free country. He claimed there is no influence to the judiciary, nor to the prison houses. But we see something else. We see that several hundred political prisoners, they are still lying in this kind of desolate situation in prison for number of years, maybe 2, 3 years, 6 years, 7 years. Why are they kept? Why can't they bring them before courthouse? If they have some kind of allegation, they should come in, should be brought before judiciary, or they should release them. They haven't done that. And one person has died recently, others died early. And why this is so? Actual business, actual people who have robbed the country, when they are arrested, the judiciary gives them another decision. We hear that they are being given freedom to go to hospitals. They are conditioned hospitals. And they are brought back to the judiciary, to the courthouse, in air conditioned ambulance. How can that happen? Why these Tamil prisoners suffer in this manner? Alternately, separately, we find that the fascistic rulers of the past who have been arrested now, they are being brought back. They are there again by the judiciary. They have got permission to go to various hospitals and come in these air-conditioned vehicles. And how can they have that freedom while these people are suffering? What is the justice? And we hear the Prime Minister of this country claiming that unconstitutional freedom has been given to the prisoners, the one prisoner, one person who has been asked to come before the courts. He has gone to courts, Supreme Court, asking for relief, not to be arrested, and he has been given 3 months of condition. And Prime Minister says that it is unconstitutional. So we find that the judiciary is under pressure from whom? Not from the government, but from the latent government of the fascistic people in this country. The fascistic clan has more power than Prime Minister, and that is how we have got this kind of release from the judiciary. That is what we have to say. Who else can this happen? Now the Prime Minister is demanding, whether he has demanding some form of redress, and he says that he has to go to Commonwealth organization and go to judiciary in London and ask for a judgment for this matter. So that's the way out for this country. So we find that this is an unbearable situation where the judiciary of this country has been influenced not now, not by the government, but by the fascistic powers which are operating underground. And they have put pressure on the judiciary and the prison houses. And they are prepared, they are powerful enough to get decisions from the judiciary and also to keep the political prisoners of last period under such condition that they die without medical assistance. So therefore, we have to take a serious step, and we have to unite all forces of democracy and have a campaign and see that this situation does not continue. We are all with Prime Minister, and we ask the Prime Minister to take note of all aberrations that you can see in the judicial system, including the prison houses, and we should take a step to redress, and not only at the higher level, but at the lower level where people are.